this channel. From this video, we will start our discussion on an entirely new concept of numerology, which is going to be on the topic of birth date number or psychic number. I mean to say, I've already uploaded a lot of videos on the concept of numerology on my this English channel, but somehow this topic got skipped and I was thinking about re-uploading and starting to upload videos on numerology as well. So I just thought of why I shouldn't start with the topic, the most important topic, which somehow got skipped from my mind. So I mean to say, guys, for all of you people who are first time listening to this concept of numerology on my this channel, so numerology can be understood as a divine science of understanding the planetary vibrations in your life through numbers. I mean to say, if you will compare the science of numerology with palmistry or with astrology, so astrology and palmistry still requires a lot of intricate calculations. But when we compare it with the science of numerology, just by finding out someone's birth date number or complete date of birth, and after finding out someone's name, you can fairly tell a lot about that person's innate nature, his preferences, likes, dislikes, vocation choices, a glimpse of future, character analysis. So a lot of information can be determined just by calculation of these basic numbers through the science of numerology. So I mean to say, and one more thing, if I were to share my own personal experience, many times, guys, what happened is that, see, you cannot be always on the top of, like, in which zodiac sign moon is transiting right now, or in which nakshatra moon is transiting. But when we talk about understanding and figuring out the omens, having those sudden realization, or let's say, for example, if your sixth sense is actually very strong, you have the capacity to imbibe the universal energies, you know, completely aligning yourself to the consciousness, super consciousness. So I mean to say, here the science of numerology actually helps, where you can fairly see that universe has the capacity, nature has the strength and capacity to communicate with you through numbers. So I mean to say, numerology has also got lot of its features, and I've already explained that in different videos which I have uploaded on my this channel so far. But like the way I was telling it to you, that if you have to understand numerology on a, and you have to start it from a very basic level. So three numbers which holds paramount importance in the science of numerology are, first being your birth date number or the psychic number, second being your life path number, and third being the destiny number. So first I will give you a quick overview of these three numbers. Like, for example, when we talk about the birth date number on which our today's discussion is going to be, so birth date number just tells about whichever day you are born on. That day's energies just tells about your innate personality. When we talk about what, how do you see yourself, your personality, your innate talents, your identity in this world, all of that can be figured out just by making a fine calculation of someone's birth date vibrations or energies only. I mean to say, let's say, for example, if someone is born on 15th of January, so the vibrations and energies of the number 15 is actually going to define the personality of that native. But for example, if that 15th January in some other person's case will become 15th of March or 15th of April, that is just going to create a difference in the form of changing the attitude. But what you define yourself as, that can be easily calculated, that can be easily determined just by the birth date numbers energies only. Guys, if you have to understand this number's importance, so many numerologists also consider this number as a very important phase. This number's energies determines the most important growing and prospering phase of your life, which is from 28 years of age till 56 years of age. Like, for all those people who know the science of astrology, so around 28 or 29 is the time when first Saturn return happens, and 56, 57 is the time when your second Saturn return happens. So I mean to say, we all try to establish ourselves in this world, in this society, carving our own niche, establishing ourselves, making and creating our own identity in this world. So that is the time period when your this birth date number or psychic numbers energies dominate. So this is something, or this is the importance of this birth date number or the psychic number. The second number which I'm going to tell you about is the life path number. So life path number gets calculated by making a sum total of your date of birth, month of birth and year of birth. So this number just tells about your path in this lifetime. So what is going to be your soul purpose? That is something which we get to know by making a sum total of someone's life path number. And if you will see, even in the life path number, one of the contributing element is the birth date number or psychic number only. Now if you have to understand the vibrations of this third most important number, which is the destiny number, which we calculate from the vibrations of your name. So the kind of energies you exude, the kind of energy which you reverberate, that we get to know by making a sum total of the corresponding letters of your name with the numbers, and making a sum total of it and reducing it to a single digit. So that just tells about the environment and the energies around you. That is the only reason in all those cases where people are not able to connect with their aspirations or fulfill their ambitions, and if in their charts, in their important numbers, there is some misalignment of energy, so then in those situations numerologists recommend to change the letters of the name so that to invite positive desired energy. So I mean to say, these all are the features of the destiny number or the name number, but somehow out of all these, it's your birth date number or the psychic number which dominates. I mean to say, so friends, the point which I'm trying to make over here is that the calculation and assessment of someone's birth date number or the psychic number works on the underlying principle of reducing their birth date to a single digit. So it will be incomplete to say that someone who is born on 3rd or someone who is born on 12th or some other person who is born on 21st. So the sum total is coming out to be 3. So the Jupiter's energy, which rules the vibrations of the number 3, is going to work in a similar fashion. So this is something, guys, which I'm going to do over here is that I'm going to give you independently all the calendar days, that if you are born on 15th of the month or 21st of the month, what difference in the manifestation of the energies can happen in your life. And at the same time, when we talk about the calculation or assessment of the important numbers of your life, it doesn't only tell about your present or your probable future. It also tells about that all of your accumulated deeds and karmas in the past lifetimes as well. Because it's your karma, it's your deeds only, the results of which you cannot escape. I mean to say, you must have seen all those people who, even after doing all the obnoxious or the bad evil deeds, they still enjoy all the amenities, comforts and luxury in their life. And there are all those cases of people who have a saintly lifestyle, still they go through all kind of troubles. So somehow the reason of all these present situations are connected, and the root of which is connected with our past life actions as well. And if you have a knowledge of numerology, all of that you can fairly decode for someone. So okay friends, without any further ado, we will start discussing that what is going to be the underlying theme of your life if you are born on this particular calendar day of any month of the year. So friends, 6 is the psychic number of those born on day 6th, 15th or 24th of any month. These natives are magnetic, youthful, gentle, soft-spoken, luxury-loving, artistic, and possessors of refined taste. They attract members of the opposite sex easily and are usually loved and respected by them. They spend freely, are social, and have opportunities to meet beautiful people. They love travel and often journey to foreign lands. They are always busy.
They are overly conscious about their physical appearance and try to dress so as to always be presentable. They dislike ugliness, dirtiness, mismanagement, and disorder. They like to keep their dwelling places clean and orderly. They love to decorate their homes, rooms, offices, or places of work. They love their life partner or person with whom they live under all circumstances and try to please them. Their married life is ordinary but orderly. They do not like to be in a disturbed environment and do not initiate arguments. If someone starts to battle with them, they run from the field and are always ready for a compromise. Psychic number 6 people are clever and tactful and are able to learn about the deeply guarded secrets of others without deliberate effort. They think before they act, which gives them a slow tempo. But they like their habit of being slow and they believe that slow and steady wins the race. They are usually upset when they are expected to move quickly and spoil a task by making mistakes. They want to remain peaceful and do not like any interference once they have started their work. They also do not like anyone to act against their will, yet they are not commanding or demanding. They can keep their feelings inside and hide their anger under attractive smiles. They are secretive by nature and can keep the secrets of others, never revealing them to anyone else. They are universal friends and make good family members. They are considerate and kind to their families and understand the joys and sorrows of their kith and kin. They maintain relationships with their parents even after they leave the home. They are easily touched by the sorrow of their parents and try their best to help them. They trust their friends and family members. Because of their refined taste, sweet manners, and considerate and gentle nature, they are popular in their circle of friends and become everybody's favorite. They are extravagant. They are lucky enough to get all the luxuries and facilities of modern living, such as a house with garden, vehicles, before the age of 45. They love company and cannot live alone for long. There is a big difference between 6 men and number 6 women. So friends, after getting an idea about the energies of psychic number 6, commonly shared by all the numbers or birth date numbers of 6, 15 or 24, now we will take our discussion exclusively to the psychic number 6 people born on 24th. So a combination of two opposites, the moon which rules 2 and Rahu which rules 4. 24 is considered to be a lucky number because 2 and 4 make 6 and 6 is a lucky number. Venus rules number 6 and when 6 is derived from a 2 and 4 combination, the person has the influence of 2 and 4 and the behavior of a 6. This particular number 6 is also lucky because the 2 and 4 are in a harmonious relationship. Although 24s have all the qualities of psychic number 6 natives and are considered 6s, they differ from those born on the 15th or 6th of any month. 4 is a number of difficulty and change, and 2 is a number of change. So the lives of those born on the 24th undergo change very often. The influence of the 2 makes them helping and sincere. The influences of the 4 makes them strong and persistent. They are secretive and can keep the secrets of others. They are benefited by members of the opposite sex, yet they also suffer from failures brought to them by betrayal. They are gentle and helpful. If their life path number and name number are in harmony with their psychic numbers, they can enjoy very good family lives. Because the positive traits of this number could be, it could make someone artistic and creative, responsible, humanitarian, loyal, dependable, unselfish, harmonious, balanced, just, righteous, lover of home, domestic life, generous, and always carrying the thought of welfare of others. So friends, the summary of your birth date number is, with this birth date, you must keep very active or you will suffer from wasted energies. You will concentrate on one thing at a time, but you will crave frequent change. You must not plan to retire from business or service, but keep on expanding and enlarging. You are strongly allied to art, music, and sculpture, have considerable talent for the stage, and are thoroughly dramatic in nature. But you will have financial success as a banker, promoter, a business person, or merchant. You can also make money in real estate. You are practical, but a little inclined to dream. Externals count for little with you, and you have not much appreciation of the value of time or money. You have a decided domestic quality and a highly developed ego. You are inclined to magnify your joys and sorrows. Avoid depression, jealousy, and worry. You will learn much through your powers of observation. So this is something, friends, which I wanted to share as a part of my inputs for all those people born on 24th day of any month. For furthermore updates and notifications on the divine science of numerology, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and like my Facebook page. Thank you.